smart bulbs are all the rage these days, but the idea of making an intelligent light bulb is actually a lot older than you might think. Here I have three of the first ever smart bulbs introduced by Philips in 1994, and they can do more useful things than just glow in different colors. They were sold under the name IQ Lighting. It was based on a development by Beacon Technology. The Chicago Tribune wrote about these bulbs in their May 29, 1994 issue with the headline, Smart Lighting. They said that Philips IQ lighting bulbs were sold at Sears and other large grocery and home center stores, and they cost about $4 to $5 each. They had several different varieties of these, more than just the three I have here. This one is a dimmer bulb, the light that works like a dimmer switch. Here it says, welcome to the IQ lighting series from Philips. The dimmer has a microchip built into the base of the bulb, which allows you to select four light levels in any socket. You can choose the perfect amount of light for any task or mood without having to install special wiring or fancy fixtures. And also lasts twice as long as standard incandescent bulbs. The directions are simply placed into any regular lamp or wall fixture. When first turned on, the highest light level will appear. To change to lower levels, simply turn the light switch off and on again. If the bulb stays unlit for any 10-minute period, the microchip will automatically reset itself to the highest level. And here it mentions that the technology in this bulb was developed by Beacon Light Products for its brand of computerized light controller components inside this product. And they list two patent numbers. The first patent was filed on April 28, 1989. The inventor was Samuel A. Johnson of Eagle, Idaho.
You are all weirdos.
Ugh. And it shows the schematic of the circuitry inside the light bulb. Notice it mentions a microprocessor. And yes, indeed, if we look in the text, it says the device is a single-chip 4-bit microcontroller being readily commercially available, having internal random access memory, RAM, read-only memory, ROM, and input-output drivers. The many possible operating modes of the complete power controller and the controller responses to momentary interruptions in the applied AC voltage are determined by the computer program resident in internal ROM. And if we look at the second patent, also filed by Samuel A. Johnson of Beacon Light Products in 1990, it shows how they were able to fit that microchip and the rest of the circuitry into the base of the light bulb, right in the bottom where it screws into the socket. And in the diagram here, we can see number 11 is the microchip. So yes, these light bulbs have a built-in microchip right here in the base, which is basically a computer. It has RAM and ROM and input and output, and it runs a computer program telling the light bulb what to do. And this may look like an odd shape for a light bulb, but Philips was no stranger to making odd-shaped light bulbs. For example, in the 1980s, they had square light bulbs.
It's time to change your light bulb. Philips longer life square bulbs last 33% longer than ordinary round bulbs.
But this diamond-shaped design wasn't their own idea. It was actually GTE Sylvania who came up with that idea in the early 1980s, and they called these the capsule light bulbs. I have a few of those. Halogen capsule light. So that was Sylvania's idea, which Philips copied. So let's try out this IQ lighting dimmer bulb with the built-in computer chip in the base. I'm going to put it into this desk lamp here and turn it on, which is the maximum brightness. My watt meter is showing 103 watts. Now if I turn it off and turn it back on, it dims down to around 83 watts. It said 70 watts, so that's a little bit higher than what they said. Then we should get the next step of dimming if we turn it off and on again. And that is around 65 watts, which they said should be 40 watts. Then once again, turn it off, turn it on again. And this should be the final stage of dimming, which I'm reading 45 watts, which they said should be 20 watts. So we're not quite matching the wattages claimed on the packaging. So now if I turn it off and back on again, we're back to full brightness and 103 watts. So it does work as intended, it just doesn't quite match the advertised wattages. Next we have the IQ Lighting 6-hour timer bulb. Turns itself on and off each day. Perfect for home security. It's a 60 watt bulb. And I'll show you at the top of the bulb here. It says timer 6-hour Philips 60 watt 120 volt. And there's that computer chip built into the base. It says Beacon, the company that invented it. 6H stands for 6-hour timer bulb. This one says the timer has a built-in microchip that will automatically turn the bulb on at the desired time and off after 6 hours. Ideal for post lanterns, porches, garages, living rooms, bedrooms, and other suitable locations where you desire security and safety. Directions are turn the light on at the time you would like it to go on every day. It will automatically shut off 6 hours later and will repeat the function each day until you reset it. 1 minute prior to shutting off, the light will blink. If you like to turn it off before 6 hours, simply turn off the switch and then back on to the on position. The bulb is controlled by the microchip, not by the switch, so it will remain off until the preset time the following day. You can also turn on the light at any time without having to reset it. Simply turn the switch off and then on. The light will remain on for 2 hours or until you turn it off. To reset the starting time, turn off then on at desired time. So this one's a little bit more complicated in its operation. It's kind of limited by the fact that the only way to control this is by turning it off and back on again. That's the only way you can control that microchip. I'm not going to make you wait 6 hours to watch this bulb turn off, so I set up a time lapse. So let's take a look at that now. And the time lapse was too fast to catch it, but a minute before it turned off, it did blink twice. And as advertised on the carton, the 6-hour timer bulb turned itself back on exactly 24 hours later. Philips also sold a 30-minute timer IQ lighting bulb, which is the same idea as the 6-hour timer version I demonstrated, except obviously it shuts off after 30 minutes. And one thing you may notice about these bulbs is how they slowly increase in brightness when you turn them on. It sort of fades on. That's how they were able to get these to last twice as long as a regular incandescent light bulb, because I'm sure we've all seen many light bulbs that just give you a bright flash when you first turn them on and they burn out instantly. That's because of the high amount of inrush current going into the bulb's filament. When it starts to get weak, that's a common cause of it burning out. So by slowly increasing the brightness, it helps to avoid that. And that's how these are able to last a lot longer. And this one claims 60 watts, it's drawing 64 watts. So that's pretty close. And the final IQ lighting bulb I have to demonstrate here is the NiteLite Plus bulb. Dims to a nightlight over 20 minutes. They say the NiteLite Plus operates like an ordinary 60 watt light bulb, however it can dim down to a nightlight level with a flick of a switch. And the directions say simply turn the light on and you will have a standard 60 watt light. Turn the light off and on again and it will dim down to a nightlight level over 20 minutes. To bypass the dimming process, turn the light off and on for a third time and it will immediately turn into a nightlight. And this one has by far the slowest fade up of brightness when you first turn it on. Takes a couple seconds, but there it is at full brightness, 63.5 watts. And as the instructions said, you turn it off and turn it back on, and now it's going to slowly fade down to a nightlight over 20 minutes, but immediately it's already dimmer at 44 watts. And then once again, you can turn it off, turn it back on, and now it's in the nightlight mode, which is not a very energy efficient nightlight because it's pulling about 18 watts. And you can see it's pretty dim. I have my camera on manual exposure. And if you want it to return to full brightness, you can just turn it off and turn it back on again. And once again, it slowly fades up to full brightness. So once again, instead of having you wait for 20 minutes to see it dim down, I'll use a time lapse. I'm sure people today are programming their smart bulbs to slowly fade down to a nightlight level when they're getting ready to go to bed, but Philips was doing it here in 1994. One disadvantage of these bulbs that's mentioned on the packaging, it says the electronic module in the nightlight, or any of these bulbs, may contribute to minor AM radio interference. And I can demonstrate that here. Turn on my AM radio to a weak station, and turn on the light. As for why these pioneering smart bulbs didn't catch on, I can think of several reasons. First was simply their high price. People weren't willing to spend $4 for a single light bulb when you can get a pack of four regular light bulbs for less than that price. Also, because the only way you have to control this bulb is by turning the power on and off in a certain sequence, that means their functionality is not immediately apparent to anyone who is not familiar with the light bulb, and may cause undesired results, such as the light bulb unexpectedly dimming down or turning itself off when the person operating it did not intend it to. And although these claimed to last twice as long as a regular incandescent light bulb, it's still eventually going to burn out when you might rather just have that computer chip on its own to insert into a light bulb socket that you could put any regular light bulb into and have the same functionality. And at the same time, in 1994, that's exactly what you could get. The same technology from Beacon was also licensed by the Angelo Brothers Company, better known as Abco, and instead of making it into a complete light bulb, they designed it as an insert to put underneath a regular light bulb to turn it into a smart bulb. They called it the Bulb Boss. It's described here in this Tampa Bay Times article as a microprocessor computer chip module that attaches to the base of an existing incandescent bulb. And they mention the same functions as the Philips IQ lighting bulbs, such as the nightlight, the four-way dimmer, and the automatic shutoff function. They said no tools or wiring are required. You attach the bulb boss to the base of the bulb and screw the bulb into your standard base socket. The bulb performs normally until you activate its bulb boss function by turning the switch off and on. They said the modules will last about 10 years and will make bulbs last twice as long, and they cost about $9 at hardware stores and home centers. So that's been a look at the first ever smart bulbs introduced by Philips in 1994, the IQ lighting series. With a built-in computer chip, very advanced technology for its time, but the market just wasn't ready for it yet.
Oh, the magic's gone. The minute the lights go out, you fall asleep.